Welcome back to Jersey Matters. I'm Larry Menta. Here now to respond to the governor's economic plan is the new chief government affairs officer for the New Jersey Business and Industries Association, Chrissy Buetas. Thank you so much. I appreciate you doing this.
Thank you, Larry.
Let's talk about, since you got the job 7 months ago.
What
do you do? What is your job?
So I have the pleasure of representing New Jersey's businesses, working with a great team here at NJBIA, and we're out advocating on behalf of our members and talking about ways that keep New Jersey competitive and ways for our businesses to grow and thrive here.
But it's government affairs, so you deal with the governor's office, you deal with the legislature for the most part?
Yes, have a great working relationship with everybody that you mentioned. Pleased to work with them on developing policy, as I mentioned, to help the businesses in the state.
And you're basically lobbying for businesses, right?
Correct.
So you're lobbying for businesses with the governor, and so this economic plan is very important to you.
Yes.
Just give me a first blush impression of what he said.
Absolutely. We had the pleasure of speaking with Tim Sullivan from EDA and others from the administration on what was coming from the governor's plan that was unveiled yesterday. And we're really pleased to hear that the governor is going to be implementing a plan to really invest in the state's innovation sector, something that NJBIA really feels strongly about. Innovation is key to bringing back businesses to the state, and I think the governor made a real great first step in trying to bring that innovation economy back to the state of New Jersey.
It's interesting you said bring businesses back to the state. Are businesses leaving the state?
Well, I think what we're seeing is a climate where businesses are seeing some uncertainty about the direction of New Jersey with different taxes being increased and you know just the competitive environment of other states and, quite frankly, a global economy right now. And when we're looking at trying to create the innovation sector, and I think the governor mentioned bringing back the Silicon Valley because New Jersey was Silicon Valley before there was a Silicon Valley, I think that's what we're referring to about bringing the innovation economy back to New Jersey.
And he's looking for investment. He's looking for money to come back into the state.
Correct.
For startups and for small businesses. And he's talking about forming this $500 million evergreen fund that everybody could tap into. Where does that money come from?
That's a question at this time, and we want to work with the governor's office and EDA to determine how is the money going to come into these new investment programs to then be distributed out to businesses. You know, is there going to be a contribution from current businesses to go into that fund? And so we look forward to working with him on how the specifics of that plan are going to be implemented.
You know, it's interesting because when he laid the plan out, you can tell that he had this Goldman Sachs background because he was talking about starting an evergreen fund, which is basically almost like a mutual fund, mm-hmm. and also that venture capitalists weren't coming into the state. Has that been a real problem?
Absolutely. NJBIA has been looking very closely into the investment of venture capital. And in fact, we talked about it at an event we had several months ago, that venture capital is just simply not investing here in the state. And that is of critical concern. Because as you know, to have a startup business takes capital. And it takes outside capital to help a small business really get their feet on the ground. So I think the partnership between the business, the venture capital, and the government together is really going to be critical to see the vision that the governor has really come to fruition.
So the way that they're going to attract venture capitalists, it sounds like, and correct me if I'm wrong in this, is with tax credits?
It sounds that way. So again, we look forward to working on what exactly that plan looks like and what the specifics are. I don't know if that has all been outlined at this point.
You keep saying specifics, so the devil's in the details, isn't it? So you're not sure where he's getting the money for this?
I'm not sure.
Are you worried about that?
I think it's going to be a give and take between the business community and EDA and just determining exactly how the program will be rolled out.
So anything positive he says about growing businesses is a good thing to you, but you still don't know exactly what he's going to do after a long speech and a platform.
Sure. We just like to see exactly what the exact plan is for that particular program, among other programs. But I think he did lay out a great first step into trying to figure out how to bring venture capital here in the state, because we do acknowledge that that is an issue.
Jersey ranks very low in so many economic factors, mm-hmm. and maybe the most worrisome is when they talk about the business climate in the state. Right. It's at the very bottom. Almost always, either the worst or next to the worst in the state. And the problem with that isn't that venture capitalist money is not coming in, and the problem with that isn't that, because it's not coming in because of something that's happening in New Jersey, right? So the thing that's happening in New Jersey is the taxes are too high. Is that it?
Well, I think taxes are too high. I think that there are some mandates as well that make New Jersey a bit of an outlier. And NJBIA, other independent organizations have evaluated the competitiveness of the state. And even the governor himself yesterday put up that we rank last in certain specific categories. And so I think that's pretty undeniable at this point, that New Jersey does have a low ranking in a lot of different areas. So what we're really focused on is making sure that New Jersey remains competitive, especially around surrounding states, because our companies, they're not only national, they're global, as I mentioned. Do they want to make sure that they're investing in an environment that they can grow and thrive? And so the competitiveness is really key for us. The predictability of business and the climate that they're entering into is really key for business to come into the state.
It's funny because I said taxes and you said other mandates. What are the other mandates?
Sure. I think that folks are very well aware that we've seen some labor mandates move forward. There's also some environmental mandates that have moved forward. And I think all of this is that cumulative impact that we keep referring to. It's not just one particular thing that a business looks at. They have a balance sheet that they look at where all of their costs are coming from. And if they're feeling some pressure coming in different areas, whether it be healthcare, whether it be tax, you know, whether it be labor, that all adds up. And so what we're saying is take all of these policies together, look at them holistically, and then see where New Jersey comes out, because we want to make sure that we aren't the outlier, especially with our competitive states around us. We want people to come here to the state, and we share that vision with the governor.
So if that's your concern, if taxes and these other mandates on labor and health costs and things like that, if that's the real problem, and that's the reason venture capital money's not coming in and businesses aren't moving in, this economic plan doesn't work, does it?
Well, I think we're going to try our best to make sure that we see innovation still come here. And I think that's not only just working with startups, that's making sure that our large institutions, our large businesses stay here, that they continue to invest here, because we know that startups want to be also around those really larger institutions so that they can work with them. I think there's that collaboration that needs to exist between not only business, but government and also our education institutions. The sharing of research, there's just so much that goes into it. So I think the venture capital is one piece of it. I think just the overall tax structure is another piece. It's the sharing of information is another piece, and it's state investment as well into bringing these startup companies here.
Now you get into lobby, and let's say you have a one-on-one with the governor and he talks about his economic plan, and at least he's optimistic and he says he wants to do all this. You'd say, here's the one thing you're missing, you have to do this. What is it?
I think we say to the governor to continue to dialogue with the business community. Let's have a comprehensive discussion about which ways that, what are some of the specifics in the plan, what are some of the things that we can work together on so that we make sure that, again, it's that comprehensive viewpoint that we look at. And I think a big part of that conversation is just making sure that the overall health of New Jersey's economy is moving forward. And what I mean by that is we all know that there are large obligations that the state needs to adhere to. Mm-hmm. And so we have to address those moving forward, because we know that there has to be investment in other areas, such as the innovation economy. So we are very focused on not only addressing things to move the state forward, like the governor is also is really promoting, but also making sure that we have those structural changes in the budget that allow us to invest in other areas to grow the economy.
I want to talk to you about possible changes in the plastic industry. I want to talk to you about possible changes in the insurance industry. And the governor came at it with his plan. The Senate president also came out with a plan. I'd like you to get you to comment on that when we continue our conversation with Chrissy Buetas, Chief Government Affairs Officer for the New Jersey Business and Industry Association, right after this.